Welcome to the second video of this series. We'll be looking at how to perform AC analysis and how to use SPICE commands. Okay, the next thing is to understand what happens to the voltage across the load as the load resistance changes. So we expect in this application our load resistance to, although it's a nominal value, might be 15 ohms, for instance, it could go down and it could go up. So I'd like to understand what happens to the voltage. Now we could either do a transient analysis or we could do an AC analysis to get the frequency response of the circuit. So let's let's add in an AC source. So I'm going to set this to sinusoidal, connect it here, update the annotations, and let's go to our simulation dashboard, and under AC sweep, I'd like to start from 1 MHz and end at 20 MHz. Now, I've realized that the M, which stands for, I assume, megahertz, if I keep this as it is, the simulation doesn't work. So I'll have to change this to 1 to the power 6 and 20 to the power 6, and I'd like to 100 points and set this to linear. I'd like to observe the output voltage across the load, and that is going to be VR load. I would like VR load, and I'm going to call this VR load and units in voltage. So now this is my output expression. Now this is the magnitude, not the phase. So looking at the magnitude, and I'd like to do a sweep of the load resistance. So let's enable sweep here and go to settings, and let's select our load resistance. And let's say it ranges from 10 ohms up to 100 ohms and in steps of 10. So let's run this. And you can see now we are getting all our frequency responses for different load values. So if you click on one over here and you hover over the value, it should tell you what load resistance value this is. In fact, we could add more points to our simulation for the AC analysis to get a more better result. So let's do that. Let's go 300 points, run that again. And here we go, that's much better. So if you click on one of them, and if you scroll your mouse wheel, you can actually cycle between all of the waveforms here. And of course, you can adjust the mask level and see if you set this all the way down, then this is the only waveform you see. And this is a nice way of making sure that the waveform that you're interested in is the one that's highlighted, and to compare it against the other waveforms. So we can see what happens here is that as our load resistance is very low, 10 ohms, we get this AC performance. In fact, I'll add the cursors as well so that we know. So we're operating at 6.78 megahertz, around 6.78 megahertz here, which is shown by this peak waveform. Now, interestingly, you would expect that because we're operating at resonance, is that the load voltage, no matter what the load resistance, will always peak at the operating frequency. But what we get here is something called a bifurcation phenomenon, where the peak voltage, the frequency response, starts to split, and eventually we have two peaks at two different frequencies. So we have the first peak at 5.7 megahertz, and the second one is at around 9.4. So this tells you that if we keep our frequency of operation the same, yes, the voltage across the load will change as the load resistance changes. What we could do is we could shift the operating frequency to either of those peaks to maximize the voltage across the load. Of course, in some wireless charging applications, you're not allowed to change the frequency, and others you are allowed. So it depends on the application itself. But this is sort of a common phenomena in wireless power system for voltage-driven coils, where you have the voltage, the AC response, the voltage across the load, the waveform starts to split. Okay, the next step is to sweep the coupling coefficient, because we expect in this application our distance between the coils to also change. So if we try to do an AC analysis now by sweeping the coupling coefficient, so if we go to settings and let's add in a parameter and let's set that coupling K1, and I want this to change from 0.1 to, let's say, 0.8 instead of 0.1. Now watch what happens when I try to run this analysis. I get an error, unknown parameter K1 in sweep command, and that is because when sweeping coupling coefficients, you need to define it as the parameter. So we need to now start using inline spice commands, and to do that, we'll just simply add in a text frame. Let's drop it right here. And Altium's documentation says that we need to first start with the command .nsx, then we put in our spice directive, which is .parameter, and I would like to define a parameter, and for the coupling coefficient, I'm going to call it coupling underscore k with a default nominal value of 0.5. So there we go, we've defined our parameter, and we need to go back to our mutual inductive component and just replace the coupling factor value with the name of the parameter. So we do that, and to do it, let's do a quick test to see if this actually works. So uncheck sweep for now. Let's do a transient analysis, and if we run that, simulation does work. However, I'm not getting any voltage on the load anymore. So, and that is because we didn't disable this AC source which we placed initially. So remember to disable sinusoidal sources if you put them in your schematic. So let's go back and just run this analysis again. And in fact, now we do have a voltage as what we had before. So let's then do now a sweep of the coupling coefficient. Go back, enable the sinusoidal source, and go to our AC analysis. And same settings from 1 to 20 megahertz, 300 points. And this time, when you go to the sweep settings, let's, instead of choosing K1, now we've got the coupling K that's available to us. And so the same parameters from 0.1 to 0.8. And now if we run this AC analysis and similar thing, we now have our waveforms, our frequency response waveforms. And as the case with the varying the load, we have the same phenomena here where the frequency response peak starts to split at two different frequencies depending on the coupling factor that we have here. So now we've done both sweeps for the coupling factor and the load resistance. In fact, you could have both two sweeps at the same time. So if we go now and enable our load, and if you run this again, and let's have a look at our curves. Now we have both the responses for the sweeps of the load resistance and the coupling factor. And this is the end of this video. In the next video, we'll be looking at how to use spice models.